Victorian drivers will be warned of speed camera locations next week as police resume their pay fight with the government. The union is pressing for a new $800 million pay deal after rejecting the last offer.
The next Victoria Police operation won't be targeting motorists. It'll be warning them about speed camera locations and plastering slogans on their cars as they push for a further $340 million from the government after rejecting a deal worth $500 million.
We negotiate in good faith. And this is always best when both parties come to the table in good faith.
In May, both parties thought the year-long fight was over after agreeing to a 4% pay rise and an extra 22 days off a year.
We talked to our delegates yesterday and they unanimously endorsed, so I suppose you'd have to say it is a good deal for our members.
But not good enough. The union is now demanding a 6% annual pay increase over the next 4 years. Secretary Wayne Gatt says our members have seen other workers receiving higher pay rises and they feel the importance of their work should attract the same rewards. In June, the government agreed to give nurses a 7% annual pay rise.
Look, we value our nurses. They're worth every cent that they get.
There's no doubt when you're looking at the deals across industry, across the public service, you'd be looking and saying, well, like for like.
The government is already under siege with wage negotiations. Firefighters have rejected a deal from Spring Street, demanding double the proposed pay rise and more bonuses. Paramedics have taken similar action after 18 months of failed negotiations.
The core problem for the government is they have run out of money.
Bethan Yeoman, 7 News.